Hi guys, I'm Ina from Sewingmachina and today I'm going to show you how to sew wrap skirt Willi. It comes in three different lengths, mini, medium and long, and you also have the choice of sewing the front piece with or without pleats. If you choose to sew it with pleats, I'd recommend any woven lightweight fabric with a nice drape like viscose satin or crepe. This is a micro satin and I've sewn the medium length. For the version without pleats, you can also use sturdier wovens like cotton, double gauze, linen, or in this example, I've sewn the mini length from a fake leather. Now let's start with the cutting. I made an overview of all the pieces that you will need. You will only need one of the two left front pieces, of course. In this tutorial, I'm sewing the skirt with pleats, but the steps are identical. It's really important that you are cutting both front pieces as well as the facing pieces with the right fabric side facing up, because otherwise the pieces won't match up. There is already 1 cm seam allowance included in the whole pattern. Here I'm transferring the markings to the fabric. I prefer just to clip little notches into the seam allowance, but you can also use any kind of tailor's chalk or similar. Now I'm going to cut the back piece. It is the only piece which is being cut on the fold, and I already cut out the dart, so it will be easier to transfer it to the fabric. Now this is how I transfer the dart to the fabric. I will clip into the seam allowance at the dart legs and I'm adding a pin to the dart point. Then I remove the pattern and I will use my ruler to connect the dart point with the markings, and it's really important that you are drawing on the wrong side of the fabric. Here I'm cutting the facing pieces, and just a little reminder to cut these pieces with the right fabric side facing up. Don't forget to transfer the markings here as well. Now I'm going to fuse the interfacing to the facing pieces. In the step I forgot the slit piece, but it needs interfacing as well. The interfacing is being fused to the wrong side of the fabric. I will place it on the interfacing and just cut it out roughly. I prefer to use baking paper to protect my ironing board, and I'm unfolding the interfacing with the facing pieces. And then I will add another layer of baking paper to protect the iron, and then you can just fuse it really well. Once you're done, you can just cut out the pieces neatly. Next, I'm gonna pin up those back darts with the right sides together. Your marking will help you to align them properly. This is what it should look like, and then you can start sewing with a regular straight stitch. Start at the end of the dart legs and go all the way down to the point. Don't backstitch here, just leave a little bit of thread and tie some knots to secure it. The last step here is to press the darts to the sides. Now we're going to sew the ties. Just grab the long and short ties and place them with right sides together. Pin all the way around, just leave the short end open because this is where we will turn it back to the right side. Now I'm going to sew with 1 cm seam allowance and a regular straight stitch. Once you reach the corner, leave the needle in the fabric, raise the presser foot, rotate your fabric, lower the presser foot, stitch until you reach the second corner, leave the needle in the fabric again, raise the presser foot, rotate your fabric, lower the presser foot, and continue sewing. If you proceed this way for all corners, you will get a really nice tip. Just a little reminder at this point to leave the short end open. So apparently I had too much tension, but it doesn't matter. Now I'm going to clip off the seam allowance at the corners. And once this is done, I'm going to turn the ties right side out. Now we're going to top stitch the ties. And before we do that, we are going to pin all the way around. I have this special technique of rolling the edge between my fingers to bring the seam up and then just pin it in place. So this is what it should look like. And now we're going to sew. I'm using a little distance to the edge of maximum 5 millimeters. And I'm going to stitch all the way around. Here again, make sure to get nice corners by using the same technique as before. And once you're done, just give the ties a really nice press. Now we're going to sew the facing. Place the pieces with right sides together. There are markings on each piece. Make sure to match them up correctly and just pin it in place. Now I'm going to sew with a regular straight stitch and the usual 1 centimeter seam allowance. And once this is done, I'm going to serge the bottom edge of the facing. This is the longer and wider edge of that facing piece. Now we're going to fold the pleats. If you're sewing the version without pleats, just skip the step and go to the next step. So here the right fabric side is facing up and I would just fold the fabric with right sides together so that the first two markings on the left are matching up. Then I would just put a pin into that marking and fold back the fabric. And I will align the waistline edge and just pin it all in place. Now I'm going to repeat the step with the next two markings. Just match the markings up, add a pin right at the marking, fold back your fabric and align the waistline edge. There are total 3 pleats, so repeat this step 3 times and pin everything in place. Now this is what it should look like from the wrong side of the fabric, and now I'm gonna secure the pleats by running a basting stitch within the seam allowance. Now we're gonna sew the side seam and just place the skirt pieces with right sides together and pin along the side seams. Make sure to only catch 2 layers of fabric and not 3, so you are still able to unfold it like this. Now I'm going to sew the side seam with a regular straight stitch and 1 centimeter seam allowance. And once this is done, I'm going to serge the side seams. Now I'm going to give the side seam a really good press and I'm pressing the seam allowance to the back. I'm going to press from the in and outside to get a really nice seam. Now we're going to put all the pieces together and here is the skirt with the right fabric side facing up. I'm grabbing the left tie, the little one, and I will pin it right between the markings at the left side. And this is the long, the right tie, and I will pin it right between the markings at the right front piece. And then I'm going to place the waistband facing with the right sides together, and I will pin along the entire waistline. So the ties are basically sandwiched between the skirt and the facing piece. Once this is done, I'm going to sew the facing to the skirt with 1 cm seam allowance. Try to get nice corners here as well and make sure not to shift the pleats if you have some, and also try not to sew any unwanted puckers by a mistake. Now I'm going to cut off the corners like here. And also I'm going to clip into the seam allowance along the entire waistline, because this is a curved edge and it will look way nicer once we have understitched it. Next, I'm going to finish off this raw edge with my serger. Now, once this is done, we're going to understitch it, and that means that you're basically unfolding the facing again and you are stitching the seam allowance to the facing really close to the original seam. And this is what it should look like from the right side. And now we're going to give the waistline a good press. Next, we're going to stitch right here to secure the facing, and we're stitching right at the side seam in the ditch. It prevents the facing from rolling out. Now we're going to sew the slit, and therefore grab your slit piece and draw a rectangle of 6 by 1/2 cm right at the center of the slit piece. So the slit piece will be located at the left front piece, right next to the side seam. And I'm going to add some pins to make sure that the facing is not being shifted. Then I'm going to add the slit piece with right sides together, and it aligns with the side seam and also with the upper edge, but in my case I left a little distance, and then just sew it right on the fabric along the rectangle. Now, once this is done, just cut it open through all of the 3 layers and cut right into the corners so that you will get some little triangles. Now we're going to fold the slit piece to the inside. This is a bit fumbly, so make sure to use a lot of pins and keep everything in place. So it will look something like this, and now I'm going to stitch it down all the way around with a very little distance to the slit. Now, before you hem it, please check if you like the length. You can always shorten it before. Now we're going to sew a straight line with the distance of 1/2 cm along the whole hemline. You have to fold back the facing to do that. It will look something like this, and then just place it under your presser foot again with the wrong fabric side facing up, and then just fold it to the inside right at the seam and stitch as you go. You can of course also use pins if you feel insecure. For me it works pretty well without pins. I will just fold as I go, and I'm stitching close to the edge, and I always fold it half a centimeter to the inside, and I will do that along the whole hemline. Once you're done, it will look something like this, and I will now trim off the excess seam allowance, like here. And then I will just repeat the exact same step. I will place it under my presser foot with the wrong fabric side facing up, and I will fold it again half a centimeter to the inside, and I will stitch as I go. So this is the final result from the out and inside. It will be a bit wavy now, which is normal. Just give it a good press. This was the last step. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any question, feel free to leave a comment or reach out on Instagram.